We welcome you to Los Angeles. Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the Toronto Blue Jays taking on the Los Angeles Dodgers. First pitch coming at you right after the break. All right, ready to go here. And now here is Whit Merrifield.
The second baseman, Whit Merrifield.
And he deals.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Wanted to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
DeLuca settles under it. One away. Here's Kiermaier now. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list. Next one misses, 2-1. And you played behind guys, and they loved having your speed out there defensively. One of the things that we talk about is how much pitchers enjoy having those elite defenders behind them. DeLuca makes the play. That's out number two.
The shortstop, Bo Bichette.
The pitch. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Mookie Betts will get us started. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on-base and slugging too. Got him looking as the fastball runs back over the inside corner. Freddie Freeman up to the dish. 1-1 now.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power. But then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very comfortable. And because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball, he's a threat deep into the count as well.
Here's a 2-1. And a foul ball. The 2-2. Good eye right there. Swing and a ball lifted in the air, left field, pretty well struck, bangs off the wall. Now a relay to second, but he's in there easily.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. Just missed out on a home run right there, but he certainly hit it hard enough. Just didn't have the right launch angle to carry it over the wall, but still an excellent swing of the bat.
And up to the plate is Will Smith. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. Now two out. Max Muncy at the dish. Falling behind 2-1.
Well, with this many pitches thrown here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving the other team a really good look. He's going to have to find a way to get some weak contact, maybe a swing and miss, get into that dugout, and hit the reset button.
And now the lefty. Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. Here comes Freddie around third. He's in there. And it's 1-0.
Always feels good when you come through and get your team on the board first. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Now it's J.D. Martinez. Two outs. That one sizzling on its way through to the outfield. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Could have timed it up any better than that. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
Yeah, the batter now, Johnny DeLuca. Next offering upstairs.
It's great to get on the board in the first frame of the ball game, but here's an opportunity for them to really open things up with a couple of runners on. Let's see if they can cash in.
And the pitch. Close one. Doesn't get the call. And that's ball three. And that'll load the bases.
Now, this was a story we were paying attention to before the game. We've seen him give up walks in the past, and it's an issue once again early on.
Now it's going to be James Outman. Next offering misses, and a count 2-1. Just missed.
Look, in situations like these, the air can get really thin up there at the plate. Got to find a way to breathe and slow everything down.
That's in there, and that's strike two.
As a hitter, you don't know what to expect here in the 3-2. If he'll throw a breaking ball 3-1, he'll do it again 3-2.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Next offering is fouled back. Bases loaded, two down. Next pitch is popped up. Chapman makes the catch. Inning over. Top of the second, and here's the first baseman, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Swing and a miss, and that is strike two. And that one is inside. 2-2 now. That one hammered center field. That's back there. And that ball is gone. Vladimir Guerrero Jr. goes deep, and it ties it up. It's 1-1.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spent on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
So it's all tied up thanks to the home run. George Springer, the next to hit. Next pitch misses inside, and that's ball two.
Oh, you just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run, go back to work, focus on this next batter.
The 2-1. And that one off the outside edge. Outside corner, there's a strike. Towards first, fair ball. Around first, heading for two. Springer makes the turn at second. And he'll make it into third with a triple. Here's the catcher to hit, Alejandro Kirk. Ball to strike, the pitch. Good eye right there. Two and one now. There's the strike.
Two balls, two strikes.
And now it's filled up. Stays alive. No outs, runner over at third. This one in the air, right field. That's a base hit as a run scores.
stringing them together. That's three hits in a row. When you pop a ball up like that, you don't expect it to get you a knock too often, but right there, somehow he got it to drop in behind first base, and that's where no one could get to it.
Now it's Matt Chapman. The 1-1 is fouled off. Ground ball right side, could be two. Over to second for one. Not in time at first. It's a fielder's choice. Up to the plate, it's Brandon Belt. Here's a 1-1. Got the bat going too soon. It's strike two. Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. DeLuca hauls it in, two away. Oh, he throws it away.
Batting nine, the left fielder, number 25, Dalton Varsho.
The pitch. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. Back here in LA, bottom of the second. Now it's the second baseman, Miguel Vargas. The 1-1. Just off the outside edge.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot. Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
Miguel Rojas at the plate. Strike two.
1-2.
Runner at first with no outs here. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. Back to the top of the Dodgers order. Here's Mookie now. Struck out looking at the bottom of the first. And 1-2. And a pitch. And that one goes straight to the backstop. So a wild pitch allows the runner to advance. Two now. One out and a runner at second. Swings and misses, struck him out. Here comes Freddie Freeman up to hit. One for one with a double and a run scored. Man at second.
Ball.
Looks like he's being a little cautious with him in this at bat after doubling the first time up. Doesn't want to make another mistake.
Just off the outside edge. Three balls and a strike. Freeman will take his base.
So here we go again with the walks. It's been a real struggle finding the zone for him in the past. Now, even if they get out of this jam, he wants to add pressure and stress to the entire team.
Kicks and fires. Not even close there. Now two balls and a strike.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Ripped, but it curls foul. Two down. Fouls it back with two strikes. Here comes a pitch. That one missed. So both runners should be on the move here on the full count pitch.
Yeah, this is a good chance to tie up this ball game. See if he can find some open grass in the outfield.
Here's a swing and a drive. This one headed down the left field line. If it's there, it's gone out of here. He made him pay for that one, and that's how they take the lead. It's 4-2. Here's Max Muncy, that funky Muncy. Singled and drove in a run his first time through. Next offering is downstairs. Two down, nobody on. And that's downstairs and outside. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. And that'll do it. Back here at Chavez Ravine, top half of the third inning. Whit Merrifield up to the plate. The wind of the pitch.
So after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
Just missed.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Three balls, two strikes the count. And down on strikes he goes. Leadoff hitter gone in the third. Here's Kevin Kiermaier. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most.
Two balls, one strike.
Swing and a miss. Two and two now.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive because there are certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit or they may have extra bases, and he
can't come up with it. Throw to first, gets him. Good job to stay with it there for the second out. Bo Bichette up to the dish. 0 for 1, he struck out swinging last time. Righty delivers. That's in there. It's a ball and two strikes.
And what makes him even quicker is the fact that he's so dialed in on the pitch as it's moving through the hitting zone. He can see how that hitter's lined up, what he's trying to do, and where that pitch is going to end up, which gives him that really quick first step.
Now that's strike three and the third out. So we take a break. Back here at Dodger Stadium, ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's J.D. Martinez. The wind of the pitch.
You know, these Dodgers showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. Pitch count is pretty high, and they've plated four runs already, so I think it's safe to say their game plan is working out pretty well right now.
And here it comes. Into center. Kiermaier moving under it. Hauls it in for the out.
So they forced the starter to put in a lot of work, and they've been able to get to him for some runs. And hopefully that bullpen phone is working today.
One down, base is empty. And a liner out into right center for a base hit. And now here's a speed threat, outfielder James Outman. And a 3-1 on the way. Popped in the air, left field. Varsho makes the play, two away. Miguel Vargas steps to the plate for the Dodgers. One for one with a single and a run scored so far. The lefty ready, and a 1-1. That one off the bad part of the bat, just a lazy fly ball. Springer there makes the catch, and that will end the inning. And welcome back. On to the fourth. And now the first baseman, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. The 1-1 is fouled off.
Well, these Jays doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way, and I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of them. They're doing a good job of working the pitch count, and they've been able to push a couple of runs across to score as well.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out, and now one away. Here's George Springer. He tripled and scored his first time.
Still relatively early, but with a pair of runs already on the board, the ripple effect of that high pitch count might set him up to do more damage later in this game.
In there for a strike at the bottom of the zone. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. One gone, runner at first. Alejandro Kirk digs in now. One for one with a single so far. The 1-1. Springer on the run. That one lifted to left. DeLuca under it. Drops into the glove. Two down.
Good pitch. He just kind of had him out in front on that pitch away and wasn't able to stay close.
Now Matt Chapman at the plate. The next offering misses. Full count now.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Blows the high heat past him. That's a strikeout. Bodie Francis into the game.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their guys a chance to fight back into the game.
Here's the shortstop at the plate, Miguel Rojas. He struck out swinging at his first at bat. That one misses. Two balls and a strike. Fastball right back to the mound. The throw to first. One up, one down. Now it's Mookie Betts. Who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. So two down now, and here is Freddie Freeman. Next pitch misses, 2-1. And that's outside. Left-hand batter waits. 3-2 now.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
Next pitch is outside.
Pretty easy to give up on that pitch right there. Started on the edge of the plate with the spin. You know it's going to finish well off the plate.
And that's just foul. And there's a ball.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Left field, way back there. Garcia ranging back and caught on the warning track. Back here at the ballpark, ready now for the fifth inning. And now the DH, Brandon Bell. The pitch. And that one a little bit high.
Well, these Blue Jays showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. The starter's pitch count is high because they've worked the count full against him five different times. Their pitch selection's been off the charts today.
Struck him out without a swing. Couldn't pull the trigger on a fastball at the knees. And now it's Dalton Varsho. Kicks and deals. And a count 1-2. Next one misses 2-2.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
That one the other way, and that's a base hit.
Everything came together for him. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Hit in the air, right field. Betts hauls it in, and there's two away. And stepping in is the speedy Kevin Kiermaier.
Kevin Kiermaier.
Ball and a strike, and he swings over the top there.
Here in the fifth inning, and here he is about to throw his 100th pitch. Man, he's really had to grind through to get to this point.
The 1-1 is fouled off. Swings and misses. It's a strikeout. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three. Welcome back. Here's a big power threat. Max Muncy. Right-handed reliever. That misses the zone. Now 2 balls and a strike. Swing and a miss as he was out front. Righty to the plate. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle, allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws.
Next offering is down low, and it's 3-2. Nobody out, runner at first. At the belt and fires. Maybe a 2-ball. 5-4.
He's out.
3. And they turn the double play.
I think there's always something pretty about watching a 5-4-3 double play get turned. I mean, just seeing the ball whipped around the diamond with quickness and accuracy, that was nice.
To the right side, Merrifield. That's the inning. Phil Bickford gets the call from the pen.
Still a lot of game left, and this game could go either way. So this is a big opportunity for him to get some important outs and try to help carry this lead into the later innings.
So digging in, Bo Bichette. He's got the power, but great contact skills. One of the best contact hitters in the game. Swing and a miss.
Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit, slightly up, slightly in.
Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Next offering is fouled back.
Well, he hasn't gotten the result yet, but he's got to feel pretty confident. Three foul balls in a row. He's right on this guy.
Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout. Here's Vladimir Guerrero Jr. He's already homered here in this one.
Vladimir Guerrero Jr.
Slow roller up the middle. To first, two quick outs to open the top of the sixth.
Deceptive slider right there, stayed in the tunnel a long time, got that hitter out front, rolled over it, put it on the ground.
The 1-1. That one drifts inside. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Muncy on his way over. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. Back here at Dodger Stadium. Well, we go bottom six. Now here is James Outman. Going to count 1-2.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there and just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
And it gets by him.
Good two-strike hitting right there, Boog. A bit of a lost art for some, so that was nicely done to beat the odds. Once you get the ball by the pitcher, there's a lot of base hits up the middle, even on ground balls. So a nice job to use that big hole and get himself a hit.
Now, here is Miguel Vargas. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And that's the first out. Now it's the shortstop, Miguel Rojas. Here's a 1-1. Swing and a ball ripped out towards right center field. That'll touch down for a hit. Into third now. So runners at the corners and one out.
He was all over that one. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy. Didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep. Took the barrel right to it and then extended through the swing for the line.
Bounce to third. Knocks it down. He pulls into second as a run scores.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. I'm amazed at his ability to pull his hands inside and actually square that baseball off. That pitch was off the plate. So tough to get the barrel to anything in there.
Swings and sends a rocket to right. And George makes the grab. Runner tags up for third. And he moves up a base. So two away with runners at the corners. The batter now will be Will Smith. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. In the air, out towards right center. Kiermaier on the move. Can't get there, and now maybe extra bases. Flying around third is Betts. He scores as well, and the lead is up to five. He's safe at third. It's a two-run triple.
Nicely done. Brings home two. Put a really nice balanced swing on it. And when you can rope one into the gap like that, you're thinking extra bases from the first couple of steps out of the box. And he'll feel real good about that one.
New pitcher now for the Jays, Mitch White.
Gets an opportunity to square off against his former team. So I wouldn't be surprised if he came out a little extra jacked up right here.
And now it's Max Muncy. Foul ball, and it remains a full count.
The strategy of winning a ball game, when you could make that pitcher work a little more, expose himself by throwing pitches, that could be the key to winning perhaps later on. So good job of extending this inning, getting a knock with two outs.
He pulls it down at second, and that ends the inning. Back here in L.A., we go to the top of the seventh. Here's the Toronto catcher, Alejandro Kirk. The 1-1 is fouled off. And it's even up.
It's a good take.
Good job to fight that one off. Comes a 2-2. High fly ball out to center field. Outman makes the grab. And there's one away. Here's Matt Chapman.
Third base, Matt Chapman.
In the air, out towards left center. Outman pulls it down, and there's two gone. So up next for Toronto, Brandon Bell. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. High fly ball, pretty well struck out towards right center. That's back. And out of here. Brandon Belt goes deep, and they're chipping away. It's 7-3. Base is empty with two away. Here's the left fielder, Dalton Varsho.
Showed a really nice opposite field approach in his last at bat.
Swing and a miss, and now 2-2. Left-hand hitter waits. Got him. Third out. And welcome back. Now it's the DH, J.D. Martinez.
J.D. Martinez.
And a pitch.
Nope.
Late with the swing there.
Two ball, two strike.
And that's too high. Payoff pitch. The punch out there, and one away in the bottom of the seventh. Now the left fielder, Johnny DeLuca. That one out to right. And it stays fair. Makes the turn and heads for second. In safely. It's a double and his second hit.
Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
And here is James Outman. The next pitch misses, and it's 2-1. Runner at second here, one gone. That clips the inside corner for a strike. The next offering misses, and it's 3-2. And a swing and a miss, two gone. Next to hit, Miguel Vargas.
The second baseman, Miguel Vargas.
The 1-1. Outside. Clips the corner. It's 2-2. Man on second, two down. Got him looking. Called strike three and a fastball up in the zone. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Ryan Brazier.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
Here's the second baseman, Whit Merrifield.
The second baseman, Whit Merrifield.
And that one is inside. Next pitch is inside, and now 3-1. Righty delivers. Way out front for strike two. Fights it off. You'll see another. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four. Kevin Kiermaier next up for the Blue Jays. Singy, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. Swing and a high fly ball to left. And there's one down.
Now, these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
And that one is lifted in the air. He's got it, and there's two away. Man at first, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. next up for the Blue Jays. The 1-1. And that's in for a strike. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. The pitch. Guerrero checks his swing. Now an appeal to first. Did not go. Pickoff throw. And he's back in easily. Back over to first. And they're keeping him close. Three, two now. And there's ball four.
Not what he wanted to do there, Boog. That keeps this inning alive and gives this offense a good chance to cut into their deficit.
And it'll be George Springer to step to the plate. And a pitch. And another ball.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
Fouls one off. 2-2. Pitch and a good eye there,
and that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
That's the third. Fair ball. One run is in. Vladdy coming around third. Row cut off. Now to the plate. The tag out. That ends the inning, but they do score a run here. Back here at Chavez Ravine, out of the bottom of the eighth, and now the shortstop, Miguel Rojas. And he deals. Got him swinging. So the lineup flips over. Here's Mookie now. Not your prototypical leadoff guy. Gets on base, yes, but also some power. The 1-1 is fouled off. The pitch. Hard ground ball, base knock.
Couple of hits in a row for him here. Really protecting with two strikes right there. Now pitch wasn't even close, but man, he got the barrel to it somehow. Nice job of bad ball hitting.
At the plate, Freddie Freeman. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, a good day for the on-base percentage right there. Walk number three, and the free bags keep on coming. You down with OBP, Boo?
Next offering misses, and that's ball three. Ground ball could be two. Over to Bichette. And it's a double play to end the inning. Evan Phillips takes over on the mound. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Now the catcher up to hit, Alejandro Kirk. Swings and misses, and the count is 1-2.
Now there's a certain point where you have to commit to what you think you see, and he guessed wrong right there. Nasty slider with just terrific bite at the end.
Swings and misses, and they get the leadoff man in the ninth. And here is Matt Chapman. Now all even up. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Here's a 2-2. Gets a piece and stays alive. This to center field. Outman has this one sized up. And there are two down. Brandon Bell next up for the Blue Jays. The other way, and he beats the shift.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. Good piece of hitting going the other way with that pitch to beat the shift. You know, not a lot of guys are willing to do that, even with the shift on, because they're looking to pull the ball with authority. But it's a pretty easy hit if you want it.
They stop the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs.
That's back-to-back singles for him. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
And now Whit Merrifield the other way, and that's a fair ball. One runs in. A second scores as well, and it's a one-run game.
Got to be feeling great about that double. Big spot, and he drives in two. He really shot that one down the right field line and somehow found a way to keep it from slicing foul. One thing that was great about the approach, his head was down all the way through the pitch, and that's how you do it.
So the Dodgers have a new arm on the mound, Daniel Hudson.
Pretty big spot he's coming into, trying to strand that runner at second base. So he's going to need to make some quality pitches. He does have first open if he needs to use it.
Now, Kevin Kiermaier, swing and a miss. And a count 1-2.
As a pitcher, you know the runner on second is ready to push things with his speed. A base hit is probably going to be a big run, so you really have to execute on the mound.
Next pitch is outside.
That turns out to be a really good take right there, but you don't want to end this game with the bat on your shoulder.
Got him looking, and that ends the ball game. The tying run left stranded at second.
Well, looked like the pitcher was getting into a little trouble there, but quickly brought out a pitch that isn't what most hitters are looking for with that great velocity, but it was really good movement on the changeup. And a nice win today.
One-run game here today. Your final score, 7-6. Dave Roberts and company celebrate in the dugout. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon.
The victorious Dodgers, seven runs on 13 hits, no errors. They left nine runners on.